Students, today we are going to learn about carbonyl compounds, which are aldehydes and ketones. Carbonyl compounds are usually neutral and is responsible for many flavors and odors in the nature. For example, we have cinnamon. So aldehyde is responsible for the odor of cinnamon. Then vanilla, lemongrass, and the citronella, or even mushroom, beers, and blue cheese. Okay, so this is the general formula of carbonyl compounds. CnH2n oxygen, where the N is 1, 2, and 3. Functional group of carbonyl compound is carbonyl groups. For aldehyde, functional group is aldehyde group, CHO, or C double bond, OH. Then for ketones, the general formula for CnH2n oxygen then must start from 3 because the carbonyl group must bond to 2 alkyls. Okay, so the functional group for ketones is carbonyl groups. Okay. Let's look at the nomenclature of carbonyl compounds. So for the naming, you have to remove the E for aldehyde, replace with AL. As for ketones, for naming, the E must replace with ONE. For example, propena is propane become propanas. Okay. For ketones, hexane become hexanone. So for aldehyde, we don't need to give the number for functional groups. Okay. Because the aldehyde group always at the end of the carbon chain. As for the ketone, the functional group is at the middle, so we have to number the functional group. So give the lowest number, so it's 1, 2, 3, yeah? Okay. Give the lowest number, so don't start from here. Start from the left, right side. Yeah? So it's 3 hexanone. Okay, then the substituents follow the alphabetical order. Yeah? So chloro first, then halocene plus. Okay. So if you have double bond, the pentane change to pentene. Okay, then number the double bond. Okay, 4. So always the carbonyl group is predominant. So always give lowest number to the carbonyl groups. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So for aldehyde, they bonded directly to the benzene ring, so you use a common name, benzaldehyde. Okay, then for this exercise you try to do, write all the structural formulas of C5H10 oxygen that are ketones. Give the name. Okay, then we look at physical properties. So physical properties of carbonyl compounds, they cannot form hydrogen bonding with each other because they don't have very electronegative atoms such as fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen that is bonded to hydrogen atom. But aldehyde and ketones are polar because they have oxygen atom bonded to carbon. Okay, that's why it has a higher boiling point and melting point than the comparable alkanes. Aldehyde and ketones can form hydrogen bond in water. That's why they are soluble in water. And the solubility is about the same as alcohol. Okay? So cannot form hydrogen bond with each other, but can form hydrogen bond with water. Because water has hydrogen atoms bonded to oxygen. Okay, chemical reactions of carbonyl compounds. So carbonyl compound can undergo condensation reactions. Okay. So condensation reaction, always you have to eliminate a small molecule such as water, hydrogen, correct? Okay. Reaction of condensation is 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogens. So you have to memorize the formula. Okay. Another name for 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen is Berry's reaction. Okay, this is the equation. Okay, so we remove the oxygen from carbonyl compound, remove two hydrogen atoms from the reagent, 2,4 nitro phenyl hydrogen, so water comes on. Okay, then the carbon join up. Okay, the carbon rubber bond join up with the nitrogen. Okay, so you will get this 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen, which is an orange precipitate. Okay, another example. Okay, so just now is aldehyde, this ketone. So again, remove the water. Okay, water then join up. Carbon join up with this nitrogen. So you will get 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. Okay, one more example. Okay, remove water. So join up here. Rubber bond join up with the nitrogen. Okay. So the observation is orange precipitate formula. So this is a useful test for carbonyl compounds. Okay. Now we look at nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, so this is a mechanism where we use a hydrogen cyanide. Okay, so we have carbonyl compound has a carbon rubber bond oxygen. So it makes a carbon, because of the oxygen atoms very electronegative. So it makes a carbon has a partial positive charge. So it is prone to attack by the nucleophiles. Okay. So nucleophile is a electron pair donors. Okay, that's why carbonyl compound undergo nucleophilic addition. It has double bond, so it can add atoms here. Okay, so the lone pair of the nucleophile attack the carbon positive here. Okay, then the electrons of the double bond goes to the oxygen atom. Okay, so this is a slow reaction, so it forms the intermediate with a negative charge, so it's unstable. Okay, so very fast the negative ion here will form bonds with the hydrogens positive here. Okay, so electron goes to the CN, so form back the CN negative ions. Okay, so the products. Okay, now we look at the chemical equations. Okay, so just write the carbonyl compound VS with hydrogen cyanide and form the final product. Okay. So this is an example. So add hydrogen and the oxygen here and CN here. Okay. The next reaction is reaction with Grignard reagents. Okay, so carbonyl compound will react with the Grignard reagents. Grignard reagents are reagent with mentioned atom. Okay. So it will form the intermediate, which is unstable. So after hydrolysis with radio acid, we will form the alcohols. Okay, if you have methane, reacts with the Grignard reagents. Okay. And after hydrolysis, it will form the primary alcohols. Okay. If you have higher or behind, that means more than one carbon atom or behind, you will form secondary alcohol after hydrolysis. Okay. And finally, if you have ketones, you will form tertiary alcohols. Okay. So always the magnesium join up with oxygen and the other parts go to the carbon. Then the magnesium bromide hydroxide form. Okay, so summary. Grignard reagent reacts with methane to give a primary alcohol. Okay, react with higher aldehydes to give secondary alcohol. React with ketones to give tertiary alcohol. Okay, so this one oxidations. Okay, if you use a strong oxidizing agent, aldehyde will oxidize to carboxylic acid. If you use mild oxidizing agent, sorry, here don't have we don't use mild oxidizing agent, just use a strong oxidizing agent. Okay, so for ketone is difficult to oxidize. Okay, if you use an extreme condition like higher temperature and pressure, ketone will undergo oxidation and form carbon dioxide and smaller carboxylic acid. Okay, example here is the propanoic acid and propena and benzaldehyde. Okay, so you form carboxylic acid, propanoic acid form and benzoic acid form. Okay, so this is a now we will show the test to differentiate the aldehyde from ketones. So these are the tests. Tollens test, also known as the silver mirror test, Fehling test, and iodophone test. Okay, Tollens test, we use silver diamine ions or the silver nitrate in ammonia. Condition is warm. So observation, you will see silver mirror. Okay, so both aliphatic aldehyde and benzaldehyde can undergo this reaction. Okay, so you can see the silver mirror here. Okay, here we see this one first. Okay, so Tollens test, example reaction. Okay, when you have 1, 2, Tú metió por pena, ¿no? Okay. Tú metió por pena, okay. So, at first it's oxidized to carboxylic acid, then carboxylic acid reacts with the alkali from the salts, and silver precipitate, which is a silver mineral, okay. And benzaldehyde from the dried ion and silver mineral. Okay. So aerosol means precipitate or solid. So second test is a failing test. So, Fehling's test, the reaction is Fehling's reaction. A Fehling solution contains a copper 2 ion complex in alkali. Condition also warm. So, the copper 2 ion will undergo reduction and form copper 1 oxide, which is a big red precipitate. Okay. So, only aliphatic aldehyde will undergo this reaction. Benzaldehyde cannot. Okay. So the same as just now, the carboxylic acid is formed first, this aldehyde oxidized to carboxylic acid, then the carboxylic acid reacts with alkali from the salt, carboxylic ion. Okay, so if the question asks for balance equation, you write this one. So we use the Fehling test to differentiate aliphatic aldehydes and benzaldehydes. So this is an example. Okay, reduction. So carbonyl compound can undergo reduction, okay, using the lithium tetrahydrochloride aluminate 3 or users NaBH4 followed by value acid, or you can use halogen gas with catalyst, nickel, platinum or beryllium, or can use sodium in ethanol which generates halogen gas, okay. So this one no need to write also can. So for aldehyde, it will undergo reduction from primary alcohol. For ketone, it will form back the secondary alcohol. So these are the examples. Okay. Now we look at iodoform test. The last one. So iodoform test, also named as triiodomethane test. The reaction is alkaline iodine, warm. So it is to test the structure of methyl ketone. That's why ethanol, only ethanol and methyl ketone can give positive test. So the observation is yellow precipitate, CHI3. Okay. So these are the examples. Okay. So it will form also oxidized, will form the this one carboxylic acid. Okay, but it involves breaking of the CH3 here. So here CH will form CHI3 here. This part will break. Okay, break here. So you must have the methyl group, methyl carbonyl group. Okay. So the methyl group will form CHI3, which is a yellow precipitate. Then the remaining will oxidize and form salt with alkalis. Okay, so if the question asks for a balance equation, you write this. So this is a question you can try it out. Okay, that's all for the presentation today. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe for the next video. Thank you. Bye bye.